Tiny surface movement of HIV reveals clue for AIDS vaccine development. When the HIV virus tries to infect a human cell, there's a tiny part on its surface that opens up really quickly. Researchers at Duke Human Vaccine Institute, DHVI, found that this quick movement could be a clue for creating antibodies to fight AIDS. If the researchers are able to stop this tiny part from opening, it could be a breakthrough for an AIDS vaccine. The part that moves is called envelope glycoprotein, and scientists have been studying it for a long time because it's crucial for the virus to attach to a T-cell receptor. This glycoprotein on the envelope of the HIV virus has been captured by the researchers snapping open and shut in mere millionths of a second. The challenge is that this part of the virus keeps moving to avoid the immune system, but researchers are working on ways to target it for a more effective vaccine. A step closer to HIV vaccine, everything that everybody's done to try to stabilize this structure won't work because of what we learned, said Rory Henderson, a structural biologist who is an associate professor of medicine in DHVI and lead author of the study. It's not that they did something wrong, it's just that we didn't know it moves this way. When the virus is trying to attach to a human T-cell, a white blood cell responsible for recognizing and attacking cells infected with viruses, it first grabs onto the cell CD4 receptor, explained postdoctoral researcher and study co-author Ashley Bennett. The CD4 receptor is a protein found on the surface of immune cells, including T cells, and plays a crucial role by serving as a docking site for the human immunodeficiency virus, HIV, which causes AIDS. This connection between the HIV and CD4 receptor makes the virus's envelope structure open up, revealing a crucial binding site. The researchers recognized this event to be essential for the virus to infect the cell. Once both parts of the virus are attached to the cell, it can start injecting its genetic material. If this happens, the infection becomes permanent. Getting infected with this type of virus is a big problem because it's a retrovirus, which means once you're infected, it's tough to fight off. The researchers discovered a moving part of the virus that protects a sensitive binding site. This moving part acts like a latch, keeping the virus from opening until it's ready. Using a specific antibody to keep this latch closed could prevent the infection, pointing that the answer to a vaccine lies in this latch system, Henderson said. The question has been why, when we immunize, are we getting antibodies to places that are supposed to be blocked? It's the interplay between the antibody binding and what this shape is that's really critical about the work that we did. And that led us to design an immunogen the day we got back from the first experiment. We think we know how this works, he added. To study the virus's different states, researchers used a powerful machine called an electron accelerator at the Argonne National Laboratory. This machine produces X-rays that can see incredibly small things, even as tiny as a single atom. Since the equipment is costly and shared among many researchers, the Duke researchers had limited time to gather as much data as possible in intense sessions. The research titled Microsecond Dynamics Control the HIV-1 Envelope Conformation was published in Science Advances.